Hello everyone, welcome back to our AWS tutorial series. In today's video, we will learn about AWS Secrets Manager. We will understand it with a demo application covering two approaches. Watch the video till the end to understand which is popular and why. AWS Secrets Manager centrally manages lifecycle of secrets. When you store a secret, the AWS Secrets Manager encrypts it using the encryption key and stores it in AWS KMS, which is the key management service. And when you retrieve a secret, it decrypts it and transmits it over TLS to your local environment. Like other AWS services, you can have role-based and resource-based access for secrets too. You can enable rotation for your secrets. You can select time and range as per your policy and compliance requirements. Lastly, you can replicate secrets in multiple AWS regions, which is helpful in disaster recovery. We will use a register and login app to understand AWS Secrets Manager. It is a Springboot application written in Java language. You can find the code on GitHub. The link is provided in description. Our first approach is that we will store all the registered users, the username and password, directly in the Secrets Manager. For that, in the AWS config file, you need to provide your AWS access key and the secret key. We will trigger the application. The application is running now. We will click on Register. This is for the first approach. Register with DB is for the second approach, which we will cover later. Just enter a random name. Unique username. Registration has been successful. We can see in AWS our secret is created with the username which we provided. And in the secret value, we can see the password which we had given. Now, when we try to log in, we should be successful. Login is successful. If we try to register with the same username, let's see what we get. I get an error that the username is already exist. This happens because of an error from the AWS side that the secret of the name test user one is already present. So all the secrets within the secret manager should be unique. The second approach is using database credentials. For this, you may use AWS services like RDS, DocumentDB, or you can use credentials for your local database as well. For this demo, I'm using a MySQL DB, which is running on my local Docker. Let's fill in the details. This is the username and password for your database. We'll keep the encryption key as default. It's MySQL. My database name, which I'm using here, is the login system. And port is, we'll set a name for it, DB credentials MySQL local, and copy the same as description. Rest we'll keep as is, we don't need to replicate it. We'll not enable rotation also. Last, review and go to SRC resources application.properties. Under the AWS Secrets Manager secret name, give the recently created DB credential secret name. Now we'll run our Spring Boot app. Our application is up. We'll first confirm that there are no users in the users table. We'll click on register with DB. Just fill in the details. successfully registered. Let's confirm it here. Yes, and our user has been entered here. Since our username is a primary key or a unique key, if we try to enter any other user with that username, we will get an error. Yes, sorry, the username already exists. We also verify our login. So give the username and the password as well. Login successful message. The second approach is preferred over the first. Reasons for that are, in the first approach, we are creating a new secret for every user. For a test application, it is fine, but for real applications with 1,000, 2,000 users, it is not feasible. In case of disaster recovery, you will have to ensure all your secrets are present in multiple regions, which is a very costly affair. AWS charges you on the number of secrets stored. Even if you store for 100 customers, it will be very costly. We covered creation flow in our demo, but if the user wants to update their password, we need to handle it via a put call to AWS and also a separate delete call when the user is deleted. If we check the pricing on the AWS site, for every secret per month, $0.4 are being charged, and you are also charged for all the API calls you make. So it's 0.05 per 10,000 API calls as of today. So for a production application, can be very costly affair considering update and delete operations as well. Now coming to our second approach, DB connection is made at the start of the application and the same session is used to update or remove the user details. If you have large number of users, it is preferred that you use the database credentials storage approach. If you use your own DB, scalability and disaster recovery you would need to handle from your end. But if you integrate with any AWS DB services, which was explained at the beginning, then those scalability and disaster recovery are handled by AWS itself, of course, with some cost additions to that too. That is all I had for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Happy learning.